The depiction of death on a two-dimensional plane is often associated with a linear or mathematical perspective. However, there are more techniques to evoke the illusion of death. On this photo, we see that the clarity of the colors in front is greater than the clarity in the background. Layers of air dim the clarity. In Greek, atmos means vapor or steam. The fading of colors to the horizon is therefore called atmospheric perspective, but also aerial perspective. The classics were already acquainted with this technique of depth illusion, which is seen on this wall painting, dating from 20 years AD. In this view of a garden, the clear red of the apple suggests proximity. The other plants in the back fade to pale green and blue. So, the illusion of depth is evoked by the differences in the intensity of colors. This Greek vase from the 6th century BC shows the parting of a warrior. On this vase, another technique of depth illusion is shown, the depiction of an object or body from the shorter side. This is called foreshortening. Catching the eye is the forward placement of the left foot of the warrior, a tiny triangle with 5 circles or toes, the foreshortening of the foot. In the painting of Caravaggio, Supper at Emmaus, the foreshortening of arms and hands not only evokes the illusion of death, but also suggests an invitation to the spectator to share Christ's revelation. In this painting of Andrea Mantegna, The Lamentation Over the Dead Christ, the foreshortening of Christ's body calls up for more than only a three-dimensional illusion. As onlookers, we share the room in which Christ lies in state. This suggestion is even strengthened by the feet stretching over the edge of the marble slab. The foreshortening of this boat on the poster of Cassandre from 1935 is not only applied to create an illusion of depth, it also stresses the awe-inspiringness of the ocean steamer. With this ship, passengers will safely cross the ocean. Another technique of depth illusion, which is derived from the perception of reality, are the cast shadows of objects, people, animals or plants, all pointing in the same direction. In this watercolor, the cast shadows of the tulip strengthen the illusion of depth. By means of colors, a three-dimensional illusion of an object in a picture can be attained. This technique is called modelé. The turnover in colors gives these apples of a mosaic from the 5th century a spherical shape. The painter Giacomo Tintoretto used the modelé for his 3 apples. Also, the cherries of Paul Cézanne are a beautiful example of this technique. A special form of modelé can be found in the meander margin, framing the title page of a Bohemian liturgical book from 1140 called the Horlogium or Clock. In the technique of occlusion or superposition, an object is placed in front of another object. On the photo, the rock in front partly occludes the rock lying behind. The Egyptians already used this technique. In this picture we see that the right arm of the artisan occludes partly his breast and left arm. This holds also for his assistants on the right. The well-known linear or mathematical perspective is said to be invented by Filippo Brunelleschi. In 1426, this technique was applied for the first time by Masaccio in his fresco The Holy Trinity. This fresco can be seen in a church in Florence, 25 feet tall and just over 10 feet wide. Below that is the open tomb with a skeleton, above which are inscribed in Latin the haunting words, "I was that which you are. You will be that which I am." In the glass of wine of Johannes Vermeer on first sight, it seems that the tiled pavement is painted from a linear perspective. On reflection, this appears to be incorrect. The pattern of the tiles pulls in a strange way up to the back wall. However, if this scene was photographed with a wide-angle lens, the same effect would be produced. Thus, the painter seems to be in the same room he painted and looks, as it were, through a wide-angle lens. If one uses a standard lens, the angle of view corresponds more or less with the human eye. To photograph with such a lens somebody at full length, one has to take distance. And that's precisely what Vermeer did. He left the room when he painted the love letter. The perspective construction of the tiled pavement now corresponds with a photo taken of this scene with a standard lens. The technique of repoussoir evokes the illusion of depth by placing an object or figure, a so-called image motif, in the immediate foreground of a picture. A splendid example of repoussoir is present in Vermeer's The Art of Painting, in which the carpet, pushed aside, forms the image motif on the foreground, allowing the spectator a view of the scene at the back. In this painting of Vermeer, The Officer and the Laughing Girl, the officer is the image motif, creating depth in the picture. The painting of Carl Willink, Simeon the Pillar Saint, shows that an artist uses several techniques in order to invoke a spatial illusion.